Hello everyone, welcome to Catalysis by Vedantu. My name is Pahul and I am pretty sure you've seen some details about who I am in the beginning of the class. So people, if I'm audible and visible, write yo in the chat box, you know the drill. So today we are here to learn about polymers, yes? Now the good thing about this chapter is that it's so vast, it has so many memory related things that whenever questions come from this chapter, they are going to be from the NCRT. Hardly does anyone ask any question outside of the NCRT. And if they do, then you might be able to apply some logic over there. We'll see the questions tomorrow at 8:30. But today, we are here to revise the chapter of polymers. And the revision that we are doing today is as good as learning the entire chapter. Okay, so you'll see a lot of information that I've taken directly from the NCRT because that is a source that we need to focus on for this chapter. Now, since it is memory based, it is pretty much like inorganic chemistry, although all the polymers are organic chemistry structures. But this is like inorganic chemistry, it's all about memory. So in case you know it, good. In case you don't know it, then well, yeah, can't do much about it. Cool. So people, let's get into today's class about polymers and see, it's a very easy class, okay? The details behind how these polymers are made, what are they called, is very easy. It's just that to remember the structures might be a little difficult. Chalo, ghuste hain aaj ki class mein. First of all, let's try to understand these terms, okay? So there are three types of polymers that we can think about. First is natural polymers. Okay, natural polymers have been around in this world since I think the beginning of time almost. Yeah. So these are of natural origin and these are found in plants and animals. Natural polymers are also known as biopolymers. Yes. So one very common example of these natural polymers is the food that we eat. Yeah, in the food that we eat, we have lots of carbohydrates and proteins. And what are proteins? Proteins are just huge, long chain amino acids, isn't it? Yeah, so proteins, polysaccharides, rubber, natural rubber that we have seen natural rubber in yesterday's session as well. Yeah, then you have polymers of isoprene, silk, wool, starch, cellulose, enzymes, natural rubber, so many things, yeah. So many natural polymers are there. So these examples are really important for us. Please make sure you read the examples carefully because questions on these examples can also be asked. Okay. Then you have synthetic polymers. Now these are artificial, of course, and there are infinite synthetic polymers in the world, as you know. Yeah. You have polyethylene, nylon, PVC, Bakelite, Dacron. The list is endless. Almost everything that we have around us these days is made of out of some or the other polymer. Yeah, the laptop that I have in front of me, this pen, this sanitizer bottle that I have, this mouse, the wire on the mic that I'm using, the camera, the phone, everything. It's made out of synthetic polymers. Then you have semi-synthetic polymers, and the uses of these are not that extensive, but still these also exist. And these are natural polymers that are modified according to human needs. So that you take the entire structure of cellulose, you put a chlorine molecule there, you put a nitro molecule somewhere in the structure. So such molecules, nitrocellulose, cellulose acetate, cellulose xanthate, etc., are examples of semi-synthetic polymers. Okay, their uses are not that much these days. But still, eventually when we start going into more, you know, eco-friendly systems of living, then semi-synthetic polymers will become a very trending thing in chemistry. So that might be something that you study later on in life. Chalo. So now, my dear friends, once we've discussed the origin of these polymers, what do they look like inside their structure? There could be different ideas. You could have linear polymers where you just have straight chains going on. Yeah, these straight chains have no link with each other whatsoever. So these examples are like high density polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride, PVC. You see those PVC pipes every day. I mean, not every day, but I'm pretty sure you've seen them. Yeah, so these are represented as these straight chains. Okay, great. I'm pretty sure you can recognize the text from the NCERT. Branch chain polymers are, they contain linear chains having some branches, so they can be depicted like these straight chains, but kahin na kahin there is a branch in the middle. Yeah, kahin na kahin you've associated them with each other, so it increases the strength of the polymer that we have. Yeah, and then you have cross-linked or networked polymers. Okay, so what happens is that these cross-linked polymers are even better. Okay, they are bonded with each other, yeah, using some really strong bonds. Okay, so in branch chain polymers, you can think of these polymers having branches like this, just simplifying that structure. Cross-linked is just a fancier version of branch chain polymers. Yeah, you take these different links and you link them all over the place. Yeh isse bhi juda hua hai, this guy is linked over here as well. So you see, cross-linking is happening. One thing is associated to two things now. This guy can be linked over here, this can be linked over here, this can be linked over here. So there is multiple linking inside these single chains. So cross-linked is just, you know, linear, then some branching, then lots of branching which is linked with each other. Yeah. So these are usually formed from bifunctional or trifunctional monomers. We'll see examples of exact structures, yeah. And some cases would be bakelite, melamine, etc. I'll show you very beautiful examples of all of those. Don't worry. Cool. So, my dear friends, the first thing that we need to understand before understanding the formation of all of these polymers is how they can be formed and what do we classify them as. See, one of the cases could be addition polymers. Okay. What happens in addition polymers is two molecules combine together to make a longer molecule. So on and so forth. Yeah, over here there is no loss of any molecule. Can you see ethene? If we think something like this, okay, and in this I will also explain the chain growth system. So what's happening is, let's take ethene. What you can do is you can break it into free radicals, as we did in yesterday's class as well. Yeah, so once you break it into free radicals, what you've done is you've done some chain initiation. Yeah, I'm just talking about it in a very short manner. Of course, it will happen step by step. You will put a peroxide catalyst in the beginning, yeah. Then that peroxide catalyst will break apart to initiate the chain. Then that chain will get propagated through the entire set of molecules. You know the drill. So this guy can combine with another one of this guy, so on and so forth. It can keep on combining, and ultimately whatever you are getting is something like this, isn't it? ये आपका दो कार्बन्स है, दिस इज एसोसिएटेड टू टू मोर कार्बन्स, दिस इज एसोसिएटेड टू टू मोर कार्बन्स. डू यू रियलाइज दैट यू हैवंट रिमूव्ड एनी ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन्स? द हाइड्रोजन्स आर ऑल हियर. दीज ग्रीन लाइंस दैट आई एम मेकिंग आर द हाइड्रोजन्स, एंड दिस स्ट्रक्चर कैन कंटिन्यू फॉर इटर्निटी. आई हैवंट रिमूव्ड एनीथिंग, आई हैव जस्ट एडेड थिंग्स टुगेदर, एडिशन पॉलीमर्स. नाउ इफ यू हैव ओनली अ सिंगल मॉलिक्यूल रिपीटिंग इटसेल्फ, if you only have a single unit repeating itself throughout the macromolecule, macromolecule is just a fancy word for polymer, you will call it a homopolymer. Homo means there is only one thing that is repeating again and again. Otherwise, you could have something like this when you have butadiene and styrene. Okay, so this is butadiene. It's better to make their bond line structures as well while you are revising. When you make bond line structures, things will stay in your mind better. Okay, so butadiene, and then there is styrene. Yeah, styrene is this. So when these combine with each other, let me make styrene in a better fashion. Okay, so what is happening over here? Two different molecules are combining with each other. Can I just write pH for simplicity? This is a benzene ring. Cool. So when these two will add up to each other, the repeating units are not just one initial starting point, they are from two different species to begin with. So these are known as copolymers. Homopolymer, copolymer. The examples that I've given to you are of addition polymers, and I've also explained in brief what chain growth polymerization is. It generally happens via a free radical mechanism. You can also have carbocation or carbon ion mechanism. Those are very rare. Carbon free radicals make the most amount of sense over here. Okay? So this was about addition polymers. Now the next thing that we need to understand, okay, is about condensation polymers. Before I tell you about condensation polymers, I need to give you a specific news, a specific information, all right? And that is the test series that Vedantu has launched. You know that to give your examination, you have to practice a lot of tests, isn't it? Whenever the examination is, hopefully it happens next month itself, but whenever the examination is, you have to practice for it by taking a lot of tests. So we have come up with a test series which will have live test discussion. So if you have a test on Monday, on Tuesday the test will be discussed in a live class on Vedantu's patented platform, and you can ask your doubts and analyze your test very well. So in order to enroll for these test series, you can either enroll for a J test series or for the NEET test series, or if you're feeling adventurous you can enroll for both, but don't do that. Yeah, so if you are planning to go for NEET, all you need to do is just write this link in your web browser. Let me show you how we can do that. Just write vdnt.in/JEE test, and it will open a very beautiful web page. You can see all the details, course overview, live interactive courses, etc., etc. Sab yahan pe de rakha hai. Yeah, you can see the details of this course. You can enroll over here, and if you need a discount, then the discount coupon is right over here. PH test is the discount coupon. So more details about this are also there in the description box, also there in the comment section. When I will give you the PDF, that same comment will have the link of the test series as well. Please enroll in case you want to. And now let's get back to condensation polymers. Now in condensation polymerization, what happens is you will lose certain molecules away. Let me give you a simple example, and let's try to associate it with the specific example that is given to us over here. Okay? Let us take a very simple amine. Ye liya apne, very simple amine. Now let us try to combine it with an acid. My dear friends, I hope you remember the reaction mechanism that can happen over here. You can essentially just get rid of a water molecule. Do you remember? I'll just draw it in a different fashion over here. Okay? I can just get rid of a water molecule, and what I will get over here is an amide linkage. This is exactly what happens in proteins as well, yeah? There's an NH, and this is now linked to the acid. Great. Now what if we can do this again and again and again? Yeah, that is exactly what's happening over here in condensation polymers. You have a diamine. Yeah, what would you call this? Hexamethylene diamine, kuch aisa hi bologe isko. Yeah, so you have a diamine over here, and you are reacting it with a diacid. Diamine with a diacid. So you are creating multiple amide linkages throughout the system, and what you are getting at the end is a polymer. In this case it is known as nylon 6,6. Why should we call it 6,6? Because there are 6 carbons in the amine side, and there are 4 plus 1 and 2, 6 carbons in the acid side. Okay, adipic acid, yes. ठीक है, गॉट इट? सो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, कंडेंसिंग दीज विल रिलीज लॉट्स ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स. या विद एवरी अमाइड लिंक दैट यू फॉर्म यू विल रिलीज अ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल. Lots of water will be released in this process. So this is what happens when you condense. You get some condensation out of it. You get some water molecules out of it. So the stuff that we have over here, the condensation polymer that we have over here, is known as a polyamide. Okay. What we have over here is known as a polyamide. Polyamides in regular colloquial words are known as nylons. Okay, nylons are essentially polyamides. Do you realize you could have polyesters as well? This is an amide linkage. Another linkage could be an ester linkage, yes. So if you combine these two together, you will have esterification. Plus you will have a water molecule that comes out. So if you have alcohols, dialcohols with diacids combining again and again and again, those will be called polyesters in nature. Okay? So polyamides, also known as nylons, polyesters. Now step growth polymerization, because you think of these reactions happening step by step. One amide linkage gets formed, then this amide linkage gets formed, then this amide linkage gets formed, then step by step you grow the entire polymer. Okay, chain reaction is a little more rapid. Free radical reaction mechanism, free radical, quick reactions. Step growth polymerization, it's very similar because you are eventually forming a polymer. But step by step, one by one, these amide linkages keep getting formed. Okay. So this is your step growth polymerization. Very simple ideas over here. But yeah. So now, my dear friends, once we have what we have done till now, quickly, let's recollect our thoughts. We have understood what are the origins of polymers: natural, synthetic, semi-synthetic. We have understood what could be the structures of these polymers: linear, branched, cross-linked. And now we've understood they could be addition polymers. Homo or copolymers are possible. Condensation polymers, may I hope you understand only condensation polymers, I hope you understand copolymers are possible. Yeah, and we understood step growth polymerization as well. So we understood the build up of these polymers. How can we build these polymers? Now that we have made these polymers, let's try to understand the characteristics of these polymers. Yeah, let's try to understand the characteristics of these polymers. So then, my dear friends, you have a few different categories. First one is elastomers. What are elastomers? Elastomers are polymers that feel like elastic. Yeah, aisa kuch khinchne wala. I mean, this is not very elastic, but I hope you understand. Theek hai? So, what happens in these polymers is that their linkages are not very strong. They are generally linear polymers, but they have one or two branches in the middle so that they just don't break apart. Okay. So, generally these are linear polymers with not a lot of branching. And they are very elastic in nature because their bondings are very weak. Weak bonding, you can stretch them, you can, yeah, elastomers. So neoprene is one example. I will show you the structure of neoprene as well. So elastomers, you have your rubber bands, etc., etc. Elastomers, okay? Then, my dear friends, we have fibers. See, whenever you think of fibers, think about clothes, okay? Think about clothes. So, my dear friends, do you realize lots of our clothes are not natural in nature? Natural in nature, that's a very useless statement, sorry. Most of our clothes are not natural. Yeah, they might write 100% cotton on the back. Some of them are true. But if you notice carefully, the stitching that we have, okay, the stitching that we have on the sides, this is generally done with polyesters. Okay, you have clothes that are made out of nylon as well, you know, those threads that you have, yeah, threads are all polyesters. You have stretchable jeans that have polymers in them. So have you ever paid attention to this? Have you ever seen someone doing some stitching or knitting in your house? Yeah, let me show you what I'm trying to search for. Yeah, I'm trying to search for spun polyester yarn. Great sound effects. So if someone is stitching in your house, if someone is, you know, taking a thread and doing some work, I used to see the packets of those threads and it's always written over there, spun polyester yarn. I didn't understand it back then when I was small. I used to see my dadiji do a lot of stitching and knitting. Yeah. So spun polyester yarn are these threads. These threads, we do think they are cotton and all, but no, they are actually polymers made out of polymeric ester linkages. Spun polyester. So all the stitching that you have on your clothes, it is most likely a polyester that you have. Yeah, very interesting. So getting back over here, all right, so nylon 66 is a fibrous polymer. Then you have thermoplastic polymers. See, what does plastic mean? Plastic means you can change its shape. Yeah. Elastic means you change its shape, it comes back. That's what the meaning of elastic is. Plastic means you change its shape and it doesn't come back to its original shape. What do we mean by thermoplastic polymers? Thermoplastic means that when you heat them up, their shape changes. Yeah. I'm pretty sure you know that if you have some utensil in your kitchen, or let's say you just have a plastic bag, yeah, if you heat it up, it changes its shape. Have you ever had that incident where you have a water bottle, plastic water bottle, and you accidentally fill a lot of hot water in it? Kabhi to kiya hoga na ki plastic bottle mein galti se garam pani bhar diya. That plastic bottle changes into some modern art. Yeah. So thermoplastic polymers are those which are hard when they are cold, but they become very flexible when they are hot. When they are hot, they become plastic in nature. ठीक है, तो पीवीसी हो गया, पॉली पीईटी जो होते हैं आपके वो हो गए, या पॉलीथीन्स, पॉलिस्टरीन्स एटसेट्रा. कूल. थर्मोप्लास्टिक. एंड देन यू हैव थर्मोसेटिंग पॉलीमर्स. नाउ दीज आर वेरी वियर्ड. व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन यू हीट देम, दे जस्ट फॉर्म सच ब्यूटिफुल क्रॉस लिंक्स विद ईच अदर दैट नाउ दे बिकम हार्ड एंड दे वोंट चेंज देयर स्ट्रक्चर. Okay, so you just have to heat them up, and once you heat them up, they become really nice and solid, and then they just stay like that. So one example is of Bakelite. Okay, one example is of Bakelite. Have you seen those old phones? Old phones, dekhe aapne jo aise, you had to ring them and then pick them up. Trrr ki awaaz karta tha wo. So a lot of those phones were made out of Bakelite. So essentially think about it like this. They take liquid plastic, yeah, garam garam, usko mold mein dala. Now when you cool it down, it sets into a specific shape. And now it is a very strong, stable structure. Thermosetting polymers can't be melted again very easily. Now that you've set them, now that they have made their cross-linking, to melt them is very difficult. Fusing them again is very difficult. Theek hai? So let me show you this very interesting thing that I found online. Okay, it is known as the Bakelite phone. Bakelite is not used anymore for some reason, but yeah. Have you seen these telephones? I still have one of these in my house in Chamba. Yeah, ek lal color mein hota tha hamare ghar pe. We had a grey one and a red one. I'm pretty sure you've seen these phones. So the material that is in these phones is essentially Bakelite. Yeah, they're still available. Wow. They're still available for a cost. Cool. So thermosetting polymers, they set when you've heated them up once. Great. So we've already understood chain growth polymerization. I don't know why this page is over here. Aage badhte hain. So people, what will happen now is we will see lots of polymers, how they are synthesized and what are their uses, because questions on that will be asked. I have taken all the examples that are there in the NCERT. So for the next remaining part of the class, we will see how these different polymers are formed, what are their starting points, what are their uses, etc., etc., and try to give you examples wherever required. So first we have polyethylene. I have seen questions come on polythene, low density and high density again and again. Let's read this statement, which is straight away taken from the NCERT. Okay? Low density polyethylene, or also known as LDP, is obtained by the polymerization of ethene under high pressure. Bahut zyada pressure, 1000 to 2000 atmospheres. Can you imagine so much pressure? Yeah, lot of pressure. And the temperature is 350 to 570 Kelvin. Temperature is also pretty high. Yeah. Now, this reaction is done in the presence of traces of dioxygen, O2, or a peroxide initiator or catalyst. Okay, generally benzoyl peroxides are used. So, things like this. Okay, this is benzoyl peroxide. This is a very common chain initiator for these free radical reaction mechanisms. So, 1000 to 2000 atmospheres, 350 to 570 Kelvin, traces of a catalyst, and this will give rise to low density polyethene. Starting point is simply ethene. Kya hi hai? Yeah. Very simple starting point. Yeah. So, low density polyethene is chemically inert and tough, but flexible and a poor conductor of electricity. So, it is used in insulation of electricity carrying wires, manufacturing of squeezy bottles, etc., etc. So, things like these, okay, things like these insulations can be prepared from low density polyethenes. Okay, for all the people who are saying, please do NTA mock test solving videos, suggestion taken, I will definitely do them once we are done with our revision classes. Okay, so in July, that is our target. Kar lenge dheere dheere. They're not very difficult. You should solve them on your own before I do them for you. Okay, chalo. Low density polyethene. Now let's talk about high density polyethene. Okay, so this is formed when addition polymerization of ethene takes place in a hydrocarbon solvent. Okay, hydrocarbon solvent, something like chloroform. Yeah, in the presence of catalysts such as triethyl aluminium. ठीक है, and titanium tetrachloride. ठीक है, titanium tetrachloride, so TiCl4 essentially. Cool. Now, this catalyst is also known as the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. These guys got a Nobel Prize for discovering the Ziegler-Natta catalyst, and it's extensively used in the generation of high-density polyethene, also known as HDP. Okay, so look at this. What happens is, this happens at a temperature of 333 to 343 Kelvin, lesser temperature than low-density polyethene, and the pressure is also very less, 6 to 7 atmospheres. See, if you don't put a lot of pressure on someone, they will automatically be able to do good in life. If you put too much pressure, they will be good. But they might be a little more flexible and not that strong. Very, very bad example, but maybe you can remember. So, to create low density polyethene, you have to put high pressure. Yeah. To create high density polyethene, you have to put low pressure. However, you want to remember that. Cool. So, low temperatures and low pressures, high density polyethene. Low density polyethene will be created when you have high temperature and high pressure. So, this opposite relationship exists. Please remember that. So, this is a little more tough and hard. These are used for making buckets and dustbins and bottles and pipes. So, buckets are mostly HDP. Yeah, buckets are mostly HDP. Dustbins and bottles could be different materials. Pipes could be PVC as well. But the buckets that we have, those colored buckets, they are most likely high density polyethenes. ठीक है, चलो बढ़िया. Now moving on to Teflon. Let's see how it is manufactured here. Teflon is manufactured by heating tetrafluoroethene. So just the bigger brother. Just a fancier brother of polyethene. Yeah, you have tetrafluoroethene over here. You again high catalyst. I mean, you put some catalyst and put high pressure, and this will also get formed via free radical mechanism. Yeah, so you can again use that peroxide, benzoyl peroxide catalyst, or you can use a persulfate catalyst as well at high pressures. It is chemically inert and it's resistant to attack by corrosive reagents. It is used in making oil seals, gaskets, and also for non-stick surfaces. Let me show you an example. Can you see this? So, the surface over here, this non-stick coating, is essentially the Teflon coating. Okay, so you know that when you use these utensils for a longer time, the coating just comes off. If you can notice, there is some discoloration on this pan that I have. Is tawe pe thoda discoloration hai. Yeah, so Teflon coatings at very high temperatures, especially when we are making chapatis and parathas, the tawa exists in a very dry condition. Yes. So when you have these in under dry conditions, when they heat up a lot, their coating just comes off very easily. Yeah. Cool. So that typical coating that we have on our non-stick pans is the Teflon coating. Okay. Now, as it is mentioned in the NCRT, these are important points because these are mentioned on the side. So you are like, huh, these are something that are not important, but NTA will ask questions on these points. So Teflon coatings undergo decomposition at temperatures above 300 Celsius. ठीक है? So अगर आपने ज़्यादा heat किया उस तवे को, its coating will become very fragile. Cool, nice. So this is your polytetrafluoroethene, also known as Teflon. Right? चलो आगे बढ़ते. Then you have polyacrylonitrile. Okay, so polyacrylonitrile is essentially the addition polymerization of acrylonitrile in the presence of peroxide catalyst. Once again, peroxide catalyst addition polymerization. Okay, so abhi tak apne teen polymers dekhe hain. We've seen three specific polymers: polyethene, Teflon, and polyacrylonitrile. This is also an ethene derivative, isn't it? Ethene pe ek CN laga diya. Something similar would be polystyrene as well. So these are all addition polymers which undergo free radical reaction mechanism. Theek hai? Chain polymerization reaction mechanism. So what you get out of it is polyacrylonitrile. Now this is a fibrous polymer, okay, and it is used as a substitute for wool in making commercial fibers such as Orlon or Acrylan. You can Google them in case you want. So that synthetic wool structures that you have sometimes are made out of this polymer. ठीक है, वो fancy fancy sweaters होती है ना, चमकीली चमकीली. Wool, you know, is very harsh, very rough. So if you have just a pure wool cloth, it won't feel very soft. Polyacrylonitrile helps achieve that softness as well. So acrylic fibers have good resistance to stains, chemicals, insects and fungi. बढ़िया. Great for wearing for longer periods of time. ठीक है, polyacrylonitrile. Let's move on to nylon 6,6. Okay, so nylon 6,6 is prepared by the condensation. Okay, so this is a condensation polymer. As I told, nylons are what? Polyamides. Yes. So what are the species that we are using over here? We have hexamethylene diamine. Yeah, this hexamethylene diamine. So you should always make these structures on your own. You have 6 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah. These are your 6 carbons. Now on either ends, there is an amine. Theek hai? Hexamethylene diamine. And you are using adipic acid with it. So what is adipic acid? Adipic acid is once again 6 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. On either ends, you have acids. Okay, see, when you draw them, it becomes very simple to understand this chapter. If you don't draw them, if you just read these, then your brain will blast away. All you have to do now is just remove water molecules. Just keep removing water molecules and you will get your polymer. As simple as that. Yeah, so how do you get the polymer? This is a condensation polymer. Of course, you don't need a free radical mechanism over here because you are making polyamide linkages. So this just happens at 553 kelvins at high pressure. That's true for almost every polymerization process, isn't it? You put high pressure, high temperature under a specific catalyst. This does not need a catalyst anyway. ठीक है. सो व्हाट यू विल गेट इज नाइलॉन 6.6. ठीक है. सो दिस इज यूज्ड इन द इंडस्ट्री मेकिंग शीट्स एंड ब्रिसल्स फॉर ब्रशेज इन द टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री एटसेट्रा. सो आई विल शो यू एन एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस. हैव यू सीन दिस काइंड ऑफ अ ब्रश पीपल? ऐसा ब्रश देखा कभी? फॉर दोज ऑफ यू हु आर इन टू मोटरसाइकिलिंग माइट हैव सीन दिस ब्रश. ओके. सो दिस ब्रश दैट वी हैव, ऑलराइट, द फाइबर्स ऑन द ब्रश आर नाइलॉन. ये जो फाइबर्स दिख रहे हैं आपको, या मोस्ट ऑफ आर टूथ ब्रशेज आर ऑल्सो नाइलॉन बाय द वे. That's also a good example. So these brushes that we have, these are your nylon brushes, okay? And this is a chain cleaning brush, by the way. So when you have to clean your motorcycle chains, you can just put your chain over here and then clean it up. Okay? So nylon. This is a good example of nylon polymer. ठीक है. सो नाइलॉन 6.6, व्हेन यू हैव टू सिक्स, यू नो यू राइट 6 टू टाइम्स इन नाइलॉन, वन इज बिकॉज ऑफ अ डायअमाइन विद 6 कार्बन्स, वन इज अ डायएसिड विद 6 कार्बन्स. 6.6, ठीक है, भूलोगे तो नहीं. नाइलॉन 6.6, यू हैव अ डायअमाइन विद 6 कार्बन्स एंड यू हैव अ डायएसिड विद 6 कार्बन्स, दैट्स व्हाई 6.6. ऑलराइट, गॉट इट. चलो बढ़िया. नाउ माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव नाइलॉन 6. Earlier one was 6.6, this is just 6. Okay, so it is obtained by heating caprolactam. This is very important because this question has been asked earlier as well. Okay, they had an entire reaction mechanism. At the end, you were forming caprolactam, and then the next question was which of these polymers can be created from the final product that you obtain in the reaction. It was a comprehension type question in JE Advanced. So it is obtained by heating caprolactam with water at high temperature. So this is your caprolactam. Okay. How do we draw caprolactam? See, do you realize it is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 membered chain, 7 membered ring. So let's make a 7 membered ring first of all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What we will do is we'll join all the dots. ठीक है, ये ज्वाइन कर दिया. नाउ वन ऑफ दीज डॉट्स विच इज ऑन द टॉप इज अ नाइट्रोजन. सी, व्हेन यू ड्रॉ दीज थिंग्स ऑन योर ओन, यू विल बी एबल टू रिमेंबर देम बेटर. ठीक है, नाइट्रोजन, ऑफ कोर्स इट नीड्स अ हाइड्रोजन टू हैव 3 बॉन्ड्स ऑन इट. एंड वन ऑफ द कार्बन्स दैट इज राइट नेक्स्ट टू द नाइट्रोजन इज अ डबल बॉन्ड ओ. डू यू रियलाइज वॉट दिस इज? दिस इज अ साइक्लिक अमाइड. दिस इज नथिंग बट अ साइक्लिक अमाइड. कैप्रोलैक्टम, लैक्टम्स आर बेसिकली साइक्लिक अमाइड्स. ओके, साइक्लिक अमाइड्स आर योर लैक्टम्स, कैप्रोलैक्टम. सो वंस अगेन व्हाट कैन हैपन ओवर हियर इज दिस अमाइड लिंकेज फ्रॉम हियर कैन ओपन अप एंड इट कैन फॉर्म मल्टीपल अमाइड लिंकेजेस विद इट्स ओन सेल्फ. बार बार अपने साथ ही ये अमाइड लिंकेज बना सकता है. So you have nylon 6 over here. Why 6? Because the number of carbon atoms is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So 6 carbon atoms, one of them is the acid one and then on one end you have the amine. Okay? So it's just an amide linkage polymer. This is also a polyamide. That's why it's called a nylon. Is formed from caprolactam. Bhologe to nahi abhi? Nylon 6 mein you have just 6 carbons. Okay, if you have to quickly draw nylon 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 carbons, on one side put an NH, on one side put a double bond O, single bond O, and then just write this in brackets. As simple as that. Nylon 6. Okay? Don't forget it from now on. Chalo, aage badhte hain. Now let me get into this one. Can you guys tell me what this is? Let's try to make the polymer out of it. Yeah, this is also a condensation polymer. This is a polyester. Do you realize this will be a polyester? Isn't it? Let's try to make this polymer. In the time, you can tell me what this polymer is. Jyotirmoy, it's not my birthday. So, dosto, what will happen over here? You have ethylene glycol. So you have 2 carbons, one OH, another OH. right? Plus you also have this terthalic acid, which is benzoic acid, but with another acid. ठीक है, तो उसको भी बनाते हैं. Yes, 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 people, very nice. This is your terylene or dacron. Do you know more common name for it, by the way? See, dacron and terylene are, I think dacron is a US name and terylene is a Russian name. Or vice versa, I don't exactly remember. But the names that you're telling me are given in the NCERT, absolutely correct. Those are Russian or US names. Do you know the more common name that we have for this one, which we use in everyday life? We actually use this name in everyday life. Batana mere ko. Arey yaar, yahan jagah hi nahi bachi. Kritika, very nice. Good, 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 good. Mishika, not in Hindi. Ragishri, Yash, Aisha, very, very good job. See, I'll show you this. Pet bottles hoti hai na? Yeah, pet bottles. That is what it is. Terylene dacron, better to call it pet because that's what we use in India. ठीक है, so it's again a polyester kind of a molecule. So all you need to do is just remove one water molecule from here. ठीक है, एक water molecule remove कर देंगे यहाँ से, and what you will have eventually is this type of structure that keeps on repeating, and you just put it in brackets. ठीक है, this is just a polyester, PET. Got it? पेट बॉटल्स में यूज होता है. सो यू आर स्टार्टिंग विद इथिलीन ग्लाइकोल एंड टर्थैलिक एसिड, राइट? सो मोर डिटेल्स ऑफ इट आर ऑन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. सो दिस इज योर टेरिलीन और डैक्रॉन. आई शोड यू दिस डब्बा एज वेल. पेट बॉटल्स आर मेड आउट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉलीमर. Yeah, so this is the best known example of polyester. It's manufactured by heating a mixture of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid to 420 to 460 Kelvin, again high temperature, and the presence of zinc acetate antimony trioxide catalyst. So isme zinc hai, acetate hai, antimony hai, aur uska oxide hai. Yeah, to chalo bhul jate hain usko. Antimony trioxide, teen जो भी है, इट्स अ कैटलिस्ट, नो नीड टू वरी अबाउट इट. एंड एज पर द रिएक्शन दैट्स शोन ओवर हियर, डैक्रॉन फाइबर इज क्रीज रेजिस्टेंट, इज ऑल्सो यूज इन ब्लेंडिंग कॉटन एंड वूल फाइबर्स एंड ऑल्सो एज अ ग्लास री इन्फोर्सिंग मटीरियल ऑफ सेफ्टी हेलमेट्स एटसेट्रा. सो द थिंग इज दैट इट कैन बी फॉर्मड इन टू मल्टीपल थिंग्स. इट कैन एक्ट एज अ फाइबरस पॉलीमर, इट कैन ऑल्सो एक्ट एज अ स्पेसिफिक थर्मोप्लास्टिक पॉलीमर एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. ठीक है, बड़ा लंबा सारा कैटलिस्ट है यार, बाहर में जाए. जिंक भी, एसिटेट, एंटीमनी, ट्राइऑक्साइड, फॉरगेट अबाउट इट. बट यार, नेवरदलेस अ कैटलिस्ट दैट इज अलाउइंग द एस्टरिफिकेशन रिएक्शन टू हैपन. कूल, नॉइस. सो फाइबरस एंड दीज फाइबर्स कैन बी यूज एज ग्लास री इन्फोर्समेंट, कैन ऑल्सो बी यूज एज पेट, एज आई टोल्ड यू. Very nice polymer. Now, my dear friends, let's do an organic reaction over here. What we have taken is a phenol with formaldehyde in an acid catalyst. What you can get out of it is a multitude of products. Okay, isse kya milega apne ko? We'll get loads of products over here. We can get something like this. Okay, we can get para substitution as well. ठीक है, I can see a lot of you people are giving me the correct name. CH2OH. अच्छा ठीक है भैया. You can get multiple substitutions as well. CH2OH, CH2OH, so on and so forth. Multiple substitutions can happen. But let's first of all focus on the first one that we've made, the ortho structure. Okay, let's just focus on the ortho structure that we've made. My dear friends, if you polymerize the ortho structure, you will get something that is used in paints. The paints that you have on your walls, you will get a compound that is used in those paints. my dear friends, this is what it looks like. What you get is a structure called Novolac. Okay, what you get a structure called Novolac. Again, you can use acid catalysis over here. You can just heat it up. ठीक है, तो catalysis कोई भी चलेगा यहाँ पे. You just have to combine these things together. You are using formaldehyde anyway in the beginning. So just heat them up. ठीक है, और जितना heat up करोगे, it will turn into this Novolac. ठीक है, so you can use an acid catalyzed environment. You can also use a base catalyzed environment in this case. ठीक है, essentially you are just doing multiple substitutions on the benzene ring. Yeah, you are essentially doing a lot of electrophilic aromatic substitution again and again and again. ठीक है, so if you form this linear polymer, this is known as Novolac. Okay, it is used in paints. Okay, Novolac, Nerolac sounds very similar. I'm pretty sure you can remember that. Now when you heat Novolac with more formaldehyde, okay, when you heat it with more formaldehyde, then my dear friends, it turns into this huge mess of cross-linked polymerization, and you get the material that made that phone that I showed you, Bakelite. ठीक है, तो यहां से बनता है आपका वो फोन Bakelite, and this is your thermoplastic setting isomer. So not isomer, thermoplastic setting polymer, and you can see very beautiful cross-linking gets, you know, the cross-linking takes place over here. It's a very nice hard material, Bakelite. Cool. So start with phenol, add formaldehyde to it, and put it in an acidic or a basic environment. Heat it up a little, you will get Novolac. Heat it up even more in presence of more formaldehyde, you will get Bakelite. Basic idea behind formation of Novolac and Bakelite. Cool, I hope you won't forget it now. Then my dear friends, this is something that's very common. I think all of you have this polymer present in your house, almost all of you. So you have melamine formaldehyde polymer. So there is a compound called melamine. It looks pretty much like benzene. Okay, you have just three nitrogens instead of the three carbons of benzene, and wherever you have the carbons, you have more nitrogens on those carbons. Okay, melamine, it's a very fancy amine. You reacted with formaldehyde, and then you get a very weird resin intermediate. Yahan pe hua kya hai dosto? Can you understand what's happening over here? This nitrogen has simply reacted with the aldehyde wala carbonyl carbon. Addition reaction has happened over here. Do you understand this reaction? This is what has happened. So that carbon has converted into an alcohol. Okay, that carbon has converted into an alcohol. So this is just a resin that is formed. Organic chemistry terms mein, this is an addition reaction. Right? Over here we'll call it condensation, because you are losing a certain number of molecules eventually. Yeah, over here it's called condensation because you are leaving some molecules away. But talking about organic chemistry, this is an addition on a double bond reaction. Yeah, to chalo uske baad kya hua, when you polymerize that resin, you get the melamine polymer. You are essentially removing water molecules again to condense it throughout. Theek hai ji. Now melamines, as I am pretty sure, okay, as Naveen is saying in the chat box, unbreakable crockery that still breaks. Yeah, I mean, if you have to break it, it will break apart. But this is melamine. Yeah, yahan pe piche likha bhi hua hai, 100% melamine food grade. I don't know if you can see it written over here. I am pretty sure you can't. The exposure of the camera doesn't allow me to do that. But yeah, it says in white font over here, it's 100% melamine food grade. So this is what melamine looks like. This is the polymer. Okay, so this is a polymer. This is the melamine monomer, reacted with formaldehyde, polymerize it, of course, high temperature, high pressure, and then you get melamine. Once again, it's a thermosetting. Yeah, thermoplastic polymer. Polymer kiya heat tha, mold mein dala, now it is a very solid, stable structure. Cool. Great. Very nice. Now, people, let's move on to butadiene styrene copolymer. What is this known as? Also known as Buna S. खुद से बनाते हैं ना पहले. What is butadiene? Butadiene. What is styrene? I already told you. Styrene is double bond and then you have a pH on top. Now all you have to do is just do your copolymerization over here. Addition polymerization. It's not condensation anymore. Now once again you have addition polymerization. So क्या करेंगे उसके लिए? We'll convert this into free radicals. See how easy it is. And you add them together. ठीक है. So these will bond with each other. यहां पे ये बन जाएगा. This is the new bond that you've created. And you have formed the repeating species successfully. How hard it is to make Buna S? Not at all difficult. Yeah. So Buna S, butadiene styrene copolymer. Alright, which is written over here. Now this looks more complicated, isn't it? There are so many carbons. It's hard to understand what's written over here. But if you make it on your own, see how easy it is. So in examinations, whenever you see the questions of polymers, don't be shy to make them on your own. बड़े आराम से बन सकते हैं, ठीक है? So my dear friends, these are again copolymers. Copolymers generally have different properties than homopolymers. They are generally more tough. Okay, so butadiene styrene copolymer is quite tough and it is a good substitute for natural rubber. Natural rubber is, you know, you obtain that from plants. The next polymer that I'll show you is natural rubber. Just polystyrene. Not polystyrene, sorry. Polypropylene. Propylene kehte hain usko? No, sorry. I'm forgetting the correct name for it. I'll show you that very soon. So, natural rubber ka ye substitute hai and it is used for the manufacture of auto tires, floor tiles, footwear components, cable insulation, etc. So, these tires generally are made out of butadiene styrene copolymers. Some of the components of tires are butadiene styrene copolymers. Modern tires are now super advanced in nature. The polymers they take in modern tires are very sophisticated. They make such polymers in the laboratory that they have very good traction with the ground. But a simple example would be these basic old tires that we have. Okay? So then you have your rubber. So rubber ka apan ne pichli class mein samjha tha. Yeah, that you take this structure and then you polymerize it. Yeah, and you have to polymerize it into its cis form, polyisoprene. Yeah, ab yaad aa gaya mere ko naam. Isoprene. Yeah. So polyisoprenes are essentially your natural rubbers. So this is a cis polymer. I hope you remember it from yesterday's class. We have made this. Yeah. So this is your repeating, very simple repeating unit over here. That's all. This guy keeps on repeating. Okay, very simple repeating unit over here. That guy just keeps repeating. So this is cis polyisoprene molecules and these consist of various chains held together by weak van der Waals interactions. Okay, so for rubbers, if they are so weak that you pull them and they break apart, they're not good rubbers, right? So these rubbers keep themselves together even when you stretch them apart because of the van der Waals interactions they have in multiple chains. So ye kuch aisa exist karega. If you think about its structure, it exists something like this, as a coiled structure. Okay, so it can be stretched like a spring. Okay, it can be stretched like a spring and has elastic properties. So this is known as your natural rubber latex. Yeah, it's obtained from the rubber plant. Okay, so you have this natural rubber plant. Uska ye jo latex nikalta hai. This milky sort of a thing, that's the natural rubber latex, and this is what is used to form natural rubber. Now natural rubber is not very good on its own. It easily breaks apart. If you stretch it too much, it breaks apart. If you dissolve it in a non-polar solvent, yeah, if you dissolve it in let's say carbon tetrachloride, it will dissolve as well. It is not resistant to oxidation. Okay, It, if you put an oxidizing agent, it'll break apart, so on and so forth. So natural rubber on its own, it's a good source of inspiration for man-made rubber. Natural rubber on its own is very easily disintegrated. It's not very durable. So what you do to make it more durable, to make it more usable, is a process called vulcanization. Okay? We will take care of this weakness of this rubber with a process called vulcanization. Okay, so what is vulcanization? Vulcanization is taking natural rubber and reacting it with sulfur. Okay, so to manufacture tire rubber, there are some tires that can be made out of natural rubber as well. So pehle yehi hota tha. Now the polymers in tires are very sophisticated and advanced, especially the polymers that you get in bike tires. You have multiple regions of different types of polymers. But in old simplistic tires, you could take this natural rubber and add 5% of sulfur. What that would do is that would force, okay, that would force cross-linking to happen. So you know this was your repeating link. Yeah, this was your repeating link. Cool, take another repeating link. You take these double bonds and onto these double bonds, you just add these sulfurs. Okay, so what sulfurs can do is, sulfurs can do something like this. ओके यहां पे एक सल्फर घुस गया बीच में. सो व्हाट दीज सल्फर्स डू इज दे फोर्स देमसेल्व्स इनटू दीज लीनियर चेन्स कॉजिंग क्रॉस लिंकेजेस एंड आई एम प्रीटी श्योर यू अंडरस्टैंड बिकॉज नाउ दे आर क्रॉस लिंक देयर आर नो डबल बॉन्ड्स रिमेनिंग द सब्सटेंस द रबर बिकम्स मच लेस रिएक्टिव. है ना, रिएक्टिविटी बहुत कम हो गई इसकी. यू हैव रिड्यूस द रिएक्टिविटी, यू हैव क्रिएटेड क्रॉस लिंकिंग, द स्ट्रेंथ इज मोर, सो दैट कैन बी यूज्ड इन रबर टायर्स एज वेल. दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ एडिंग सल्फर एंड हीटिंग अप इज नोन एज वल्कनाइजेशन. ठीक है, सो डोंट फॉरगेट व्हाट इज वल्कनाइजेशन. इट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ एडिंग सल्फर एंड स्ट्रेंथनिंग नेचुरल रबर. गॉट इट? चलो, फ्यू मोर पॉलीमर्स रिमेनिंग, लाइक 3-4 मोर पेजेस. So the next one that we have is neoprene, and I'm pretty sure everyone has seen neoprene. Okay, neoprene or polychloroprene is formed by the free radical polymerization of chloroprene. So what is chloroprene? It's similar to isoprene. You just have a chlorine instead of the CH3 over there. Okay, so do you see similar polymers are kept close to each other in this book? NCRT, a very beautifully written book. I don't know why people don't like it. So you had polyisoprene, now you have polychloroprene, which is known as neoprene. Okay, so it is formed by the free radical polymerization of chloroprene, so you get neoprene over here, very similar to polyisoprene. Yeah, right. So now, my dear friends, what happens over here is it has superior resistance to vegetable and mineral oils as well. So the seals, etc., that you can make can be of neoprene. It is used in manufacturing conveyor belts, gaskets and hoses, etc., etc. So hoses are basically your water pipes that are flexible. Flexible pipes are called hoses. And gaskets, do you know what gaskets are? Do you people know what gaskets are? If you don't know, then write no in the chat box. If you know, then just write yes or yay or something. If you don't know what gaskets are, I'll explain what gaskets are. And this is something that is made out of neoprene. So neoprene is this stretchy, clingy material that you use in your kneecaps and elbow pads and etc. So all these stretchy pads that you have to, you know, protect your body while doing sports, or you know, when you have some injury in your knees, you can wear this. All those things are made out of neoprene. ठीक है, अच्छा गैस्केट नहीं पता, मैं बताता हूँ. सी, गैस्केट इज समथिंग विच इज यूज्ड व्हेन यू जॉइन टू पीसेस ऑफ मेटल टुगेदर विद ईच अदर. ठीक है, सो होता क्या है, आई विल गिव यू द एग्जांपल ऑफ, यार बड़ा सिंपल सा एग्जांपल देता हूँ. डू यू हैव दैट रबर काइंड ऑफ अ थिंगी? अच्छा, लेट्स से देयर इज अ होल दैट यू हैव टू पुट अ स्क्रू इन. ओके, उसके बीच में यू पुट अ रबर वॉशर. हैव यू सीन दोज रबर circular rubber thingies that you put before tightening a screw so that the hole doesn't leak anymore? Yeah, that is a gasket. The cooker that you have, cooker mein kya laga hota hai? You have that rubber on the cooker, right? That is also a gasket. So gaskets are these rubber components that seal your gaps efficiently. Okay, gaskets can also be there in engines. So you know engine cases are. यहाँ पे कोई एग्जाम्पल दिखेगा ऑनलाइन तो मैं दिखाऊंगा. इट्स अ लिटिल टू फैंसी बट आई ठीक है. सो दीज गैस्केट्स आर पुट ऑन इंजन्स व्हेन यू क्लोज द इंजन. सो यू हैव द इंजन सिलेंडर्स एंड यू डोंट वांट ऑयल टू कम आउट ऑफ द सिलेंडर्स. सो व्हेन यू आर पैकिंग द टॉप कवर ऑफ द इंजन, I'm putting it in layman terms. Yeah, when you're putting the top cover of the engine, you put this rubber thing in the middle so that it seals it efficiently. So the best example is your pressure cooker. Yeah, that rubber thing that you have in your pressure cookers is your gasket. ये देखो जो मैं इंजन वाली दिखाना चाह रहा था आपको. Yeah. So this is what your engine looks like. Okay. And can you see it is lined with this rubber thingy on top now? Yeah, so this rubber thingy that we've put will ensure that when you cover this engine up, the oil won't leak apart. Okay. Yeah, so gaskets are very useful. These are just rubber sealing items. Pressure cooker is the best example. Chalo, gaskets, cool. Neoprene is generally used there as well. Then you have Buna N. Okay, so we have done Buna S, butadiene styrene complex copolymer. Now over here you have butadiene acrylonitrile. Okay, so Buna S mein this CN is a PH group, this CN is a benzene group. That's the only difference. Okay, Buna N mein butadiene styrene, Buna S mein butadiene styrene, and Buna N is butadiene and acrylonitrile. So it is obtained by the copolymerization of 1,3-butadiene and acrylonitrile in the presence of a peroxide catalyst. So once again, this guy associated with this guy. As simple as that. Done. Okay. So you do the copolymerization of this jazz. It is resistant to petrol, lubricating and organic solvents. It is used in making oil seals, tank lining, etc. This is also used in gaskets. Okay. So it is also used in gloves. This is a Buna N glove, by the way. These are like waterproof, they don't allow anything to pass through them. So they are really useful in the laboratory, because in the laboratory you don't have only water, you also have lots of organic solvents that you want to protect your hands from. So Buna N gloves are resistant to everything. So one more example of oil seals that I have over here. I have this packet hai mere paas abhi bhi. So have you seen the shockers of the motorcycle? Inside the shockers, inside the forks of the motorcycle, there's hydraulic oil so that the springs can move properly. Yeah, so that the springs don't have friction, they don't just get dusted and all. So one component of any hydraulic system is the oil, and to seal the oil from coming out, you use these seals. Can you see these rubber rings that we have? Rubber ki rings dikh rahi hongi. So these will also have components like Buna N in them. These are oil seals that we have. Yeah. So these are oil seals for the front forks of my motorcycle. I have these just in case. Very interesting. Chalo ji. So that was about Buna N. Nice examples we have now for all the polymers. Now the last two polymers that we need to discuss are some biodegradable polymers, because you know ecology is very important for us, and the way humans are hellbent on destroying the planet Earth, we are not going to go very far if we keep living like this. So now we need to look for alternatives that are biodegradable, because if I throw a plastic bottle like this away, this will protect me today from the virus, but tomorrow it's going to kill a whole bunch of birds and plants and animals and insects, and then I will not have food to eat. So we are just delaying our we are just delaying the apocalypse, you can say that. So the thing is, it's necessary as humans to move towards more biodegradable alternatives that, you know, can either biodegrade on their own, or you can just put a chemical on them and then they start disintegrating into something that can gel well with other substances in nature. So one of these substances is PHBV. what is this? Poly beta hydroxy butyrate, co beta hydroxy valerate. People didn't think of a good name for this because it's not very commonly used these days. They just call it PHBV. It's just a copolymer between beta hydroxy butyrate and beta hydroxy valerate. Dekho, very simple idea is, okay, you have to take butanoic acid. बनाते हैं इसको, ठीक है, अच्छे से बनाते हैं. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. यू हैव ब्यूटेनोइक एसिड एंड यू हैव वैलेरिक एसिड. व्हाट इज वैलेरिक एसिड? वैलेरिक एसिड इज जस्ट अ फैंसी नेम फॉर पेंटेनोइक एसिड. ओके, सो ब्यूटेनोइक एसिड इज 1, 2, 3, 4. सो दिस इज योर सी डबल बॉन्ड और सिंगल बॉन्ड ओ एच. नाउ वॉट यू हैव इज अ बीटा हाइड्रोक्सी. Beta hydroxy. So this carbon is my alpha carbon. This carbon will be my beta carbon because my acid is the functional group. So alpha carbon, beta carbon. On the beta carbon, just add an OH. As simple as that. Similarly, valeric acid is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon atoms. So you have the acid end. And once again on the beta carbon, this is alpha, this is beta, you have an OH group. Okay, just for some structural similarity, let me try to make it like this. Ek second. Yeah, now it will look a little better. And then on the beta carbon, you have your OH. So, beta hydroxy butyrate plus beta hydroxy valerate. Okay, beta hydroxy. Okay, so they are just ions of these specific acids. So you take these two acids as they are mentioned over here as well. Okay, very simple. So you have butanoic acid and pentanoic acid. Copolymerize them. When you do copolymerize them, you will get this PHBV. Do you realize this is also a polyester? Essentially, it is a polyester, isn't it? Polyester ban raha hai. Khud se try karna. Try to make the polyester out of these two things. Okay? Notice whatever is given over here. Ye aisa kuch banaya inhone. Theek hai? And over here, do you understand what I'm trying to make? This and this. The rest of it is just linking them with each other. Cool. So this is your poly beta hydroxy butyrate co beta hydroxy valerate. Okay, PHBV. Very simple. Just try to make this on your own after the class is over. So it is obtained by the copolymerization of these two, and it is used in specialty packing, orthopedic devices, and in controlled release of drugs. So the capsules that you have, the outer covering in capsules is generally gelatin. And gelatin is what? It's a natural polymer. Yeah. But if you want even slower release of the drug, if you want like the drug to release itself in the body after a good number of hours or days, then this can be used. PHBV coated capsules can be used. Okay. And PHBV undergoes bacterial degradation in the environment as well. So good polymer to make substances that can last longer but can biodegrade as well. Chalo. Ye ho gaya. Now the next thing is nylon 2, nylon 6. We have already done nylon 6, 6. We've done nylon 6. Now over here we have nylon 2, comma nylon 6. So what is happening over here? You have alternating polyamide copolymer of glycine. Okay. What is glycine? You know, glycine is your simplest amino acid. Let's try to make it NH2. C double bond O, single bond OH. This is combined with another amino caproic acid. What is this? It's just an amino acid with 5 carbons in the middle. Yeah. So you have total number of 6 carbons. Yeah. 6 carbons. One of the carbons is an acid already. And one of the carbons has an amino group on it. Understood? So why is it called nylon 2, comma nylon 6? Because you have 2 carbons over here and you have 6 carbons over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Why is it a nylon? Because it is a polyamide. Nylon 2, 6. Right? Now, can we write the structure of this copolymer? Yes, definitely we can. फर्स्ट लेट्स रिमूव अ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल. ठीक है, यहां से वाटर मॉलिक्यूल निकालेंगे. सो व्हाट विल वी गेट ओवर हियर, वी विल गेट समथिंग लाइक दिस. डबल बॉन्ड ओ, सिंगल बॉन्ड ओ तो नहीं रहेगा, यू विल हैव सिंगल बॉन्ड विद NH एंड दिस इज एसोसिएटेड विद द सिक्स कार्बन्स, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This has the double bond O, single bond O dash. On the left hand side you have your nitrogen with one hydrogen and a dash. Just put brackets and you're done. ठीक है, do you understand how simple it is to create these polymers if you know the starting compounds? Nylon 2, 6, two carbons in one side, six carbons on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Cool. Very simple, once again, nylon 2, 6, and this is also a biodegradable polyamide. This is a biodegradable nylon. ठीक है जी, got it? All right. Jayant is asking, how do we determine the monomer in the polymer? See, bro, polymers are synthesized out of monomers. So if someone gives you the polymer, what you need to figure out is, can you break a link to create an acid and an amide? Amine. Can you break an amide linkage? Can you break an ester linkage? If there's an ester linkage, if there's an amide linkage, it's very easy to make the basic structure of the polymer. Otherwise, you have to try and see whether you have a double bond in the structure. Then it has come from a free radical case. For example, if I make polystyrene over here, yeah, let's just make a quick dirty version of polystyrene. Okay, this is your styrene. Okay, so if I have to make polystyrene, what will I do? I will create these free radicals right next to each other. Yeah, and now all I have to do is just join these free radicals with each other. So, kar do join. So, now you have to figure out, achha, it must have come from styrene. Theek hai? If I have to theoretically make a weird polybutadiene structure, okay, randomly, theoretically making a polybutadiene, may not exist, may exist. You will have these free radicals, yeah, so on and so forth. So now all you have to do is join these free radicals together. Kaise join karenge inko? This is a new join that you will make. This is the double bond that you will make because of the free radicals, and this will then continue. So from here you will have to realize ki achha, this double bond would have existed like this earlier. This bond could be broken. So, to determine what is the monomer from a polymer, you have to pay a little bit of attention to the structure. We might be doing some questions related to that tomorrow. Theek hai? Chalo, badhiya. Now, finally, my dear friends, the final piece of information that we have is this one. And let me show you in the complete view. Cool. So, these are some more polymers that were given at the end of the NCERT. Again, questions can be asked from these. So, that's why I have over here. Okay. ठीक है, अच्छा मैंने कुछ एक्स्ट्रा बना दिया क्या कहीं पे? हाँ, आई हैव मेड दिस एक्स्ट्रा ऑक्सीजन ओवर हियर, आई एम वेरी सॉरी. ऐसा होगा, कूल, बिकॉज द वाटर मॉलिक्यूल हैज टू लीव, सो द ऑक्सीजन इज लीविंग. आई एक्सीडेंटली एंडेड अप मेकिंग दैट ऑक्सीजन मॉलिक्यूल ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड इन नायलॉन 2, नायलॉन 6. दिस इज द रिपीटिंग यूनिट बिकॉज नाउ ए नाइट्रोजन विल बी कनेक्टेड ओवर इट. ठीक है, सिली मिस्टेक फ्रॉम माई साइड, प्लीज करेक्ट इट इफ यू डन द मिस्टेक विद मी. चलो, सो नाउ फाइनली these are the few more cases that we should keep in our minds. Okay, so you have polypropene, which starts from propene. So once again you are just polymerizing this, just showed you the example. Yeah, so manufacturing of ropes, toys, pipes, fibers, etc. Polystyrene, just showed you the example of polystyrene as well by making it randomly. Yeah, so insulator, wrapping material, manufacturing of toys, radio, TV, cabinets. See, polymers are all essentially what, plastic kind of species. Yeah, then you have PVC, polyvinyl chloride. I am pretty sure you've seen PVC pipes. Hardly would be anyone who hasn't seen PVC pipes. Yeah, so manufacturing of raincoats, handbags, vinyl flooring, water pipes, all the plastic water pipes that we have are PVC pipes. Yeah, then you have urea formaldehyde resin. Urea formaldehyde resin. Yeah, this part is coming from urea, this part is coming from formaldehyde. So this is used to make unbreakable cups and laminated sheets, etc. Okay, you have glyptal. ग्लिप्टल कहां से आ रहा है? इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम इथिलीन ग्लाइकोल एंड टर्थैलिक एसिड. इथिलीन ग्लाइकोल एंड टर्थैलिक एसिड, ये थोड़ा वियर्ड सा है यहां पे देखो तो. सो दिस इज द इथिलीन ग्लाइकोल पार्ट एंड देन यू हैव द टर्थैलिक एसिड. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो अ पॉली एस्टर एसेंशियली या बिकॉज यू आर कंबाइनिंग एल्कोहल्स विद द एसिड्स. सो पॉली एस्टर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ पेंट्स एंड लैकर्स. एंड देन फाइनली बेकलाइट, ये कितनी बारी बताएंगे पता नहीं. बेकलाइट हैज बीन टोल्ड इन दिस चैप्टर 20 टाइम्स, सो प्लीज पे एक्स्ट्रा अटेंशन टू बेकलाइट बिकॉज एनटीए माइट ऑल्सो नोटिस दिस 3 टाइम्स इन दिस चैप्टर इन द एनसीईआरटी. ठीक है? यस अतुल, इट इज द एनसीईआरटी पेज बिकॉज एनसीईआरटी इज वेयर क्वेश्चंस विल कम फ्रॉम इन दिस चैप्टर. सो रिवाइजिंग द एनसीईआरटी इज एज गुड एज रीडिंग द चैप्टर ऑफ पॉलीमर्स. अदरवाइज इफ यू हैव टू लर्न अबाउट ऑल द पॉलीमर्स दैट आर देयर इन दिस वर्ल्ड, देन वंस यू लर्न इट यू विल बिकम अ टॉप लेवल इंडस्ट्री एक्सपर्ट इन सम अमेजिंग फील्ड. ठीक है, बढ़िया, ऑसम. सो पीपल, वॉट वी हैव डन टूडे इज दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स अबाउट पॉलीमर्स. एसेंशियली इफ यू हैवंट रेड द एनसीईआरटी टिल नाउ, आई हैव डन दैट फॉर यू. सो वंस अगेन लेट मी रिमाइंड यू दैट वी हैव दिस टेस्ट सीरीज दैट यू कैन ज्वाइन. या तो टेस्ट सीरीज ज्वाइन कर लेना, आपका भला हो जाएगा. द लिंक इज ऑल्सो गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स एंड द कॉमेंट सेक्शन डाउन बिलो. द टेस्ट सीरीज कम्स विद लाइव टेस्ट डिस्कशन. सो इफ देयर इज अ टेस्ट ऑन ट्यूजडे, द टेस्ट डिस्कशन विल बी डन ऑन वेंसडे इटसेल्फ. या सो यू कैन एनालाइज वॉट एवर मिस्टेक्स यू मेड, सॉल्व योर डाउट्स इन लाइव क्लासेज ऑन वेदांतूज प्लेटफॉर्म. खोलियो, चलो. सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वॉट आई विल डू इज आई विल क्विकली शेयर द PDF ऑफ वॉट एवर आई हैव मेड टूडे. द सोर्स हैज बीन एंटायरली NCERT एंड अ लिटल बिट ऑफ गूगल. Yeah, so just give me a moment, let me share the PDF with you guys and then I will chat with you as usual for a couple of minutes and then we'll call it a day. Bum, 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 bum. Har class mein JEE main postpone, JEE main postpone. Bhai, I don't work for the government, I don't know. We will all get to know at the same time because the news channels will tell us. अभी सोचने का कोई फायदा नहीं है यार. देयर इज नो यूज थिंकिंग अबाउट वेदर इट इज पोस्टपोन्ड और नॉट बिकॉज अनलेस एंड अंटिल द न्यूज चैनल स्टार्ट शाउटिंग एट अस, जेई की डेट हुई चेंज, आइए देखें बच्चों पर क्या असर पड़ेगा. अंटिल देन द डेट इज नॉट चेंज्ड. ओके, सो डोंट वरी अबाउट इट. आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू ओपन द, एक सेकेंड, कुछ गड़बड़ सी हो गई है यहाँ पे. जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट, trying to open the video so that I can put the PDF in the comment section and the chat box. Praveen, we are starting that tomorrow, bro. Arey yaar, channel kyun nahi khul raha? Hold on, people. Kuch to gadbad si ho gayi hai yahan pe. Haan, khul gaya. Thankfully. So now I'll spam your chat box. Now that I've spammed your chat box, I am going to add the link of the PDF in the comment section down below, right next to the links of the test series. Okay. Chalo ji. Comment added. I have pinned the comment as well. Now tell me what's going on in life. Gaming Redemption is asking, suggest good books for chemistry, all subparts for JEE 2021. I have done that in my strategy session video, my friend. So just see that on YouTube. Fatafat se wo dekh lo, tum sab detail pata lag jayegi. Because there are multiple books that I have suggested. So let me show you where to go for that particular session. Okay. So yahan pe just open Catalysis by Vedantu. Just go to the homepage of our channel and when you scroll down, there would be this series, Prepare Chemistry. Just open this video. So I have told everything about what book to follow, when to read it, what not to read, how to revise 11th class if you've not done 11th class, so on and so forth. All the doubts that 2021 aspirants might have is right here. ठीक है, इट विल टेक अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ टाइम, सो बेटर जस्ट गो एंड वॉच इट राइट देयर. राजदीप वीरे मैं पंजाबी का बोल लाँगा पर सारे लोगों ने छड़ के चला जाना क्लास, तो आप अंग्रेजी की गल करते हैं वीरे. अखिल सिंह आई एम रियली इंजॉइंग लेट्स रेविट एन आर्ट ऑफ डिडक्शन, थैंक यू सो मच अखिल, ग्लैड इट इज हेल्पिंग यू. एनटीए पेपर एक्सप्लेनेशन एज आई टोल्ड यू वी विल डू इट आफ्टर द लेट्स रेविट एन आर्ट ऑफ डिडक्शन क्लासेज आर डन, सो दैट विल बी इन द फर्स्ट वीक ऑफ जुलाई वी विल डू द एनटीए पेपर्स, बट प्लीज डोंट डिपेंड ऑन मी फॉर दोज, यू शुड डू थिंग्स ऑन योर ओन एज वेल. ठीक है, तो खुद से सॉल्व करो उनको, सॉल्व दोज टेस्ट ऑन योर ओन, वी विल डू द टेस्ट डिस्कशन इवेंचुअली, डोंट वरी. गणेश येस ऑफ कोर्स आई नो गौरांग सर, साइरा वाओ ग्रेट, एरन नो आई डोंट नो व्हाट दैट इज. Gaming retention, that is the plan bro, to cover the entire 12th class and 11th class syllabus eventually. तो धीरे धीरे हाँ वही कर रहा हूँ दोस्त मैं, that's exactly what I'm doing slowly and steadily. वसंत सब सब bro. Yes, that is a very good test series, it's just that it's very difficult, so you might feel underconfident by getting the marks in it, but it will prepare you well for the examinations, especially JEE Advanced. Hydrogen marathon, yes Ishani, so the next week is for the hydrogen marathon and carboxylic acids revision and question solving, so in the next week we will cover that. Akhil, yes we are continuing that bro, aaj bhi aa gaya hoga 9 baje koi na koi meme, a meme should be there, let me check if they've put the meme, so हाँ आ चुका. इट्स एन इंटरेस्टिंग वन, लेट मी शो इट टू यू, कैन यू सी दिस इज द मीम दैट वी पुट टुडे. सो फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू हु डोंट नो वेयर दिस इज, ऑन द कम्युनिटी पेज ऑफ आर चैनल वी पुट दीज फन मीम्स एवरी डे एंड वी डू अ लॉट ऑफ फन एक्टिविटीज ओवर देयर, सो यू कैन डेफिनेटली चेक दैट आउट, वी पुट द शेड्यूल ऑफ आर चैनल देयर एवरी सिंगल डे. So make sure you check out the community page of our channel time and again. Next on Revit. So tomorrow the class is for polymers question solving. Yeah. Then there is metallurgy marathon, in which we will solve questions of metallurgy and understand the theory along with it. And next week there will be carboxylic acids and hydrogen, and then we are done with this series. Readable audio books, well that's a very utopian vision, might not happen. Yeah. And yeah, Sujit is asking what camera do you use for shooting this class. This is on my Galaxy Note 9. So I convert the webcam, sorry, I convert my phone into the webcam for the laptop. So the limitation is I can't stream anything more than 480p from the camera. So the image that you're seeing, you can scale it up to 1080p if you're watching this on the laptop. But I can't take anything more than 480p from my phone because of the limitation of the software that I'm using. I mean, there's nothing better I can do. Rajdeep, not much, bro. I am not interested in programming at all, in fact. Grignard reagents. So we have done, okay, there's a person whose name is not readable at all, he's asking for Grignard reagents. Bro, there's a class that I've done on Grignard reactions, just watch that. So just scroll through the videos on our channel, you'll find it. Otherwise just search for Grignard reactions or Grignard reagent Paul sir, I'm pretty sure you will get. Gaming Redemption, I can understand man, I can understand. Biomolecules is already done Sunita, it's already there on the channel, you can check that out. ठीक है, शुड वी मेक नोट्स वाइल गोइंग थ्रू स्प्रिंट 2.0, एटलीस्ट सॉल्व दोज क्वेश्चंस धनुष, नो नीड टू मेक नोट्स. कृतिका इज आस्किंग व्हाट्स द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ बी एस एन नो बी एस, वॉट डू यू थिंक, वाई डू यू थिंक आई हैव जस्ट रिटन बी एस एन नॉट गिवन यू द फुल फॉर्म, डिड्यूस ऑन योर ओन प्लीज. इंटरेस्ट इन कार्स, यस इन सुपर कार्स ऑफ कोर्स, बट आई कांट अफोर्ड देम राइट नाउ. how to get the correct solution of previous year J advance. Sam, they are available online on loads of websites, bro. Shubh is asking how to join NASA or Elon Musk. Just keep pursuing one stream in life, become so good that you eventually go to those countries and work for them. I'm able to solve 40-50% of the questions of MS Chauhan, just stuck after that, even if I've read the theory completely, can't just understand where is the lag. Shashi, so the thing is, the questions in MS Chauhan are very weird, and some of them are super weird, they can't really be solved easily. So don't worry, if you have done 40-50%, if you can go to 60%, great, don't worry too much about it. That's the beauty of the questions of MS Chauhan. If you can see the solutions and understand what has to be done in those questions, it'll help you understand the pattern for more tougher questions as well. Theek hai? Janvi, thank you so much. Chalo, so dosto, that's it for today's class. Let's finish it. And we will see each other once again tomorrow at 8:30 when we'll do the questions of polymers chapter. So that is going to be a quick class. There won't be a lot of... क्या ही करेंगे ना पॉलीमर्स में. नाउ दैट वी नो ऑल द इन्फॉर्मेशन वी विल जस्ट लुक एट क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर देम. सो टुमारो एट 8:30 वी विल सी ईच अदर वंस अगेन. अंटिल देन थैंक यू सो मच. इफ यू एंजॉयड द क्लास मेक श्योर यू हिट दैट लाइक बटन. स्टे सब्सक्राइब. गुड नाइट.